LGBT plus oppression is prevalent in society. The rights we've won come against a backdrop of continuing levels of homophobia and rising levels of transphobia. Around the world, LGBT plus people face discrimination in employment and healthcare, are at much higher risk of mental distress and hate crimes, and can even be put to death or jailed. In Britain, Boris Johnson's Tory government cut vital funding to LGBT plus awareness programmes in schools. So the question is why? Why does LGBT plus oppression exist? Where does it come from? And crucially, how can we fight it? Some say that LGBT plus oppression is intrinsic to human society, has always existed, or comes from religion. But as Marxists, we argue that LGBT plus oppression arose from the development of capitalism, when working people were pushed into the nuclear family. Homophobia and transphobia haven't always existed, which means we can fight for a world without them. The family is the real institution that has shaped and controlled our sexuality. In class societies, it's how the next generation is reared. In pre-class societies, same-sex relations and gender-variant behaviour was commonly accepted. And in early class societies, such as ancient Greece, relationships between men weren't regarded as unnatural. This is because society was built around a slave economy, where the family unit was less important and there was a greater separation between procreation and sex. As feudalism became the economic system in the Middle Ages, the family structure shifted. Peasants had to work the land, and this required a large family unit. Laws were passed to protect procreation, outlawing buggery, certain sexual positions, and even sex with animals. But this only criminalised certain acts, not a certain type of person. This changed with capitalism. As capitalism developed during the Industrial Revolution, people were pulled into factories in big cities, where men, women, and children were forced to work in appalling conditions. But it did mean that for the first time, people were able to explore freer sexual relations, and the working family was, according to Friedrich Engels, being destroyed. The capitalists panicked. They needed to ensure a new generation of workers were healthy and were brought up so they could continue making profit. The nuclear family, with a separation of men at work and women at home taking care of the family, were enforced. Legislation was introduced to stop women working and created the category of a homosexual person. The homosexual was now a certain type of person, outside the family, threatening its stability. While the family has undergone changes, it remains key for capitalism to reproduce the workforce. It's important to fight for our rights and reforms under capitalism, but it will always roll back our rights. Decriminalisation of homosexuality was fought for and equal marriage was won, but we still live in a system that perpetuates our oppression. This keeps exploited workers divided. Equal marriage shows that the system is willing to adapt, but only to ensure its economic needs are met. Now we see trans people in the firing line, accused of threatening family values that the capitalist system is so reliant on. We've updated our new pamphlet to offer a Marxist explanation of the roots of homophobia and transphobia, and why we need to build a united opposition to the attacks on LGBT plus people. Because the only way to win true liberation is to smash the system. And this requires protests, strikes, and mass movements to build our class consciousness and confidence to realise the power we have as workers. Of course, LGBT plus people at the top of society experience oppression, but they have no interest in getting rid of the capitalist system, and oppression affects them differently than it does those at the bottom of society. The history of fighting for LGBT plus liberation shows that the high points of working class struggle has seen the biggest advances for all oppressed groups. That's because of the unique power workers have. We are weaker divided, so the ruling class pushes oppressive ideas to keep us fighting amongst ourselves. The way to overcome this is through building working class unity. Revolutionaries have to win all workers to fight against all forms of oppression. The Russian revolutionary Vladimir Lenin argued that socialists have to be the tribunes of oppressed and had to win working people to fight for liberation for all. Unity in action cuts across ideas that are fed from the top of society that we must compete with one another or that the cause of your problems is the LGBT plus person stood next to you. So now, in LGBT plus History Month and every other month, we need to be fighting to rid ourselves of the profit-driven system, oppressive system of capitalism to win a truly liberated socialist world.